Poliomyelitis, more commonly known as polio, is caused by a highly contagious virus that is spread through contaminated food and water from infected people species.
It is usually found in landfills, sewage, and in public drinking water.
It may take from 4 to 35 days for the symptoms of an infected person to start appearing, although the virus itself can be passed from person to person by a carrier.
Polio is a virus that enters through your body through the mouth or nose. Then it multiplies in your throat and intestines. It then spreads through the blood and lymph system until it reaches the central nervous system.
The virus attacks nerve cells, in which some cases leads to paralysis. Polio is a serious condition, although it only causes paralysis in less than 1% of the people infected. There are numerous types of polio, including paralytic polio, which causes acute, flaccid paralysis, in which the person is left with paralyzed legs. Another form of polio, bulbar polio, is the most serious type of polio. It is caused by the virus infecting the brain and paralyzing muscles in the body, which cause the victim not to be able to swallow, breathe, or speak.
Some with polio experience subclinical infection symptoms. The infected person may experience discomfort, headache, red throat, fever, vomiting, or sore throat. These symptoms can last for 72 hours or less.
The symptoms involved in paralytic polio are more serious than those in non-paralytic polio. As the virus spreads through the person's nerves, it destroys the nerves that control the muscles. This infection may be fatal if the brain and respiratory organs become infected. The first tests for polio vaccines were tested on monkeys infected with the disease. In 1935, Dr. John Colmar thought he had found a cure, but it didn't work. He tested an attenuated strain of the polio virus that he drew from the spinal column of an infected monkey.
In 1948, a group led by John Enders successfully grew the polio virus in the lab, so they would no longer have to test the vaccines on monkeys. In 1952, Jonas Salk made the first successful polio vaccine, which was made from a deactivated form of the polio virus. Before this, it was believed that the virus in a vaccine had to be alive for it to prevent the disease. The Salk vaccine included three successive shots. In 1959, the oral vaccine was created by Albert Sabin.
Were first spread throughout Europe and North America. After these areas had been conquered, they moved to South America and the Caribbean. There they discovered that the oral vaccine created by Albert Sabin was more effective in developing countries because they were faster and could be distributed more easily to more people at one time. They also discovered that national vaccine days were very effective.
Polio was not seen as a major health threat in Latin America until the mid-1900s. Countries in Latin America first added the oral polio vaccine as a part of the Expanded Program on Immunization, EPI, in 1977.
Eu fui dos membros do grupo médico.
I was one of the members of the medical group that worked on some of the days of the National Immunization Days against polio in Brazil in 1984. I am sharing my experiences of those very important days in the history of Brazil. But I would like to explain the difference between what a vaccine and a treatment do against the same disease.
One thing that people sometimes get confused is regarding the differences between vaccine and treatments. They're two very different things, but sometimes the fact that you get a shot with a vaccine, it feels like you're treating a disease, but you never treat any disease with vaccine. Vaccines, by definition, are all used only to prevent a disease, so you cannot have the disease once you get the vaccine.
In the 1970s, Latin America had an estimated 15,000 paralysis cases and 1,750 deaths each year due to polio. The Sabin oral vaccine was introduced in this area in 1977. Today, polio has been completely eliminated from Latin America.
Once you get the vaccine, in this case, let's talk about the polio vaccine. You have two types of vaccine, the dead virus, the salt vaccine, or you have the live attenuated virus, that is the Sabin vaccine. These two vaccines, in the end, are going to cause the same benefits. They will expose our immune system, our defense system, to the poliovirus, and so we learn how to fight this virus with a very small dose of these viruses, so we don't get sick, but we learn how to defend ourselves against these viruses. Once we learn, we can actually protect ourselves for many, many, many years after getting the vaccine.
When Salk's vaccine was first introduced, its ability to prevent polio was questioned. However, through a series of tests, it was proven to prevent the poliovirus.
Todo ano existe uma campanha nacional de vacinação contra a poliomielite, onde...
Every year, there existed a national vaccine campaign against polio, where health-related government workers and the Secretary of Health, universities, and volunteers helped out. In my case, a medical student. I was a volunteer for this national vaccine campaign of polio. So what we did in that time was go to the most remote places of the cities, villages, and poor areas, where we brought the Sabin vaccine and went from house to house, knocking at the doors, and offered the Sabin vaccine.
The eradication of polio from Latin America was a turning point in the way the world could combat infectious diseases in developing countries. By using methods first tested during the polio eradication campaign, such as National Immunization Days, and the first vaccine made from a deactivated form of the virus.
É pedra, é o fim do caminho, é um resto de topo, é um pouco sozinho, é um caco de vidro, é a vida, é o sol, é a noite, é a morte, é o laço, é o anzol, é peroba do campo, é o nó da madeira, caenga, candeia, é uma tita pereira, é madeira de vento, tombo da ribanceira, é um mistério profundo, é o queira ou não queira,